नमस्ते बिटिया, हमेशा खुश रहो बिटिया। माइसेल्फ जेवियन डॉक्टर रितु शर्मा, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ गायनियो, फैकल्टी ऑफ होम्योपैथिक साइंस, ज्योति विद्यापीठ, वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी। टुडे सेशन इज द एंडोक्राइनोलॉजी ऑफ द रिप्रोडक्शन पर सेकेंड। नाउ स्टार्ट। स्टेरॉयडल हार्मोन्स एस्ट्रोजन इन लेट प्रेगनेंसी क्वालिटेटिवली एस्ट्रेडियोल इज द मोस्ट इम्पोर्टेंट अमोंगस्ट द थ्री मेजर एस्ट्रोजन। द साइट ऑफ इट्स प्रोडक्शन इज इन द सिंसाइटोट्रोफोब्लास्ट, फिटोप्लेसेंटल यूनिट एंड बायोसिंथेसिस ऑफ एस्ट्रियोल। The placenta is an incomplete endocrine organ as it has no capability of independent steroidogenesis like that of ovary. For steroidogenesis, it depends much on the precursor derived mainly from the fetal and partially from the maternal sources. Fetal adrenal gland and the placenta contain the complementary enzyme system. This is the key of Dick's Palsy's concept of fetoplacental, or better still, maternal fetoplacental unit. The biosynthesis pathway in the final formation of estriol is shown diagrammatically in the scheme. The estriol is first detectable at 9th week, 0.05 ng per ml, and increase gradually to about 30 ng per ml at 10. Fetal death, fetal anomalies like adrenal atrophy, encephaly, Down syndromes, 33 mole formation, placental sulfatates or anastomose deficiency are associated with low estriol. Progesterone. Before 6 weeks of pregnancy, the corpus luteum secretes 17-hydroxyprogesterone. Following the development of trophoblast, progesterone is synthesized and secreted in increasing amount from the placenta. Precursors from fetal origin are not necessary as in estrogen production. The placenta can utilize cholesterol as a precursor derived from the mother for the production of progesterone. Progesterone is converted to progesterone in the endoplasmic reticulum by 3-beta-hydroxysteroid dehydrogenase. The daily production rate of progesterone in late normal pregnancy is about 250 mg. The low progesterone observed in ectopic pregnancy and in abortion. High value are observed in hereditary mole formation and HRIO isoimmunization. After delivery, the plasma progesterone decreases rapidly and is not detectable after 24 hours. Functions of the steroid hormone estrogen and progesterone. It is indeed difficult to single out the function of one from the other. Together, they play an important role in maintain of pregnancy. Estrogen causes hypertrophy and hyperplasia of the uterine myometrium and thereby increasing the accommodation capacity and blood flow of the uterus. Progesterone is conjugation of the estrogen stimulate growth of the uterus, causes residual changes of the endometrium required for implantation, and it inhibits myometrial contraction, development and hypertrophy of the breast during pregnancy are achieved by a number of hormones. Hypertrophy and proliferation of ducts are due to estrogen, while those of lobulo-alveolar system are due to combined action of estrogen and progesterone. Both the steroids are required for adaptation of the maternal organs to the constantly increasing demands of the growing fetus. Progesterone maintains uterine quiescence by stabilizing lysosomal membranes and inhibiting prostaglandin synthesis. Progesterone and estrogen are antagonistic in the process of labor. Estrogens synthesize the myometrium to oxytocin and prostaglandins. Estrogen ripens the cervix, progesterone along with HCG and residual cortisol inhibits T lymphocyte mediate issue rejection and protects the conceptus. Diagnostic value of placental hormone. First, A is diagnosis of pregnancy. Presence of HCG in the plasma can be detected by radio immunoassay and in urine either by biological and immunological tests. Radio immunoassay can detect minute quality of plasma HCG. B, subunit soon after the implantation of blastocyst, but biological and immunological tests do not become positive at least 44 days after the last menstrual period. B, follow-up cases, bull head, trophoblastic tumors, radio immunoassay for the detection of HCG beta subunit in is more sensitive in the follow-up study of hydatidiform and choriocarcinoma. C, detection of functions of fetoplacental unit. The placental hormones commonly studied for the evaluating placental insufficiency and status of the fetus in utero are HPL and estriol. These biochemical changes have been largely replaced by biophysical profiles. Relaxin. If a peptide hormone structurally related to insulin, the main source of production is the corpus luteum of the ovary, but part of it may be also produced by the placenta and decidua. It has been claimed that relaxin releases myometrium. The symphysis and sarcolytic joints during pregnancy and also help in cervical ripening by its biochemical effect. Changes of endocrine gland during pregnancy. First is pituitary gland, then thyroid, then adrenal cortex, then parathyroid and pancreas, showing distinct physiological changes during pregnancy, leading to increase in output of respective hormones. The basic purpose of this change is to adjust the internal environment of the mother to meet the additional requirement imposed by metabolic changes during pregnancy, as well as to meet the extra demand by the growing fetus. The specific anatomical and physiological changes in the individual endocrine glands are described in the next page. The first is pituitary gland morphological changes normal pregnancy. During normal pregnancy, the pituitary increase in weight by 30 to 50% and is enlarged to about twice its normal size. This is principally due to hyperplasia of acidophilic prolactin stressing secreting cell. Sometimes the pituitary enlargement may impinge on the optic chiasma, causing bitemporal hemianopia, and maternal pituitary gland is not necessary for the maintenance of pregnancy. The pituitary gland during pregnancy become more susceptible to alterations in blood supply. Sudden hypotension following prostaglandin hemorrhage, sudden hypertension following postpartum hemorrhage may cause infarction of the gland. Hormone influence necessary for maintenance of lactation. The breast is a modified sweat gland. It consists of ducts, alveoli, and fibrofatty connective tissue. During puberty, there is a proliferation of fibrofatty tissue without any change in the alveoli ductal system. The endocrine control of lactation can be divided into following stages. These stages are: first is a preparation of breast mammogenesis, b synthesis and secretion of milk by breast alveoli lactogenesis, c ejection of milk galactogenesis, and maintenance of lactation galactopoiesis. This session is powered by digital version 2.0, Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women's University. I hope you are satisfied with my digital session. If you have any query, please mention in comment box. I will resolve it. Thank you.